What's good, Raider Nation? Y'all know who it is and y'all know what it is. It's your boy, Matthew Shaq. And we got more information in regards to this situation with the emails of our former head coach, Jon Gruden, and how it got to the public. It's starting to really look like there was, a sabotage, man. Like, it's really looking bad because certain people's names are popping up that you guys know. And one of them is Adam Schefter from ESPN. His name is being thrown around in here. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to be accurate. Okay, I'm going to read off of my other phone here because I want to be accurate. I don't want to just freestyle this. Okay, here's what it says. This is last night. Okay, several from the LA Times here, Los Angeles Times here in LA where I am right now. Several inflammatory emails by Jon Gruden was filed as exhibits in federal court by attorneys for Washington football team owner Daniel Snyder in mid-June, almost 4 months before they were leaked to two newspapers that led to Jon Gruden's resignation as the coach of the Las Vegas Raiders. So let me break that down fast. First, leak. Because now we're finding out it's a leak, but you know what a leak means. That means somebody passed that information on was to the Wall Street Journal on Friday in regards to the Damore Smith email. And then the second one, which came out on Monday from the New York Times that got Jon Gruden to resign or be forced to resign or whatever the case may be. The heavily redacted emails between Jon Gruden, I'm reading this verbatim off of my phone, okay? Between Jon Gruden and then Redskins president Bruce Allen, filed in U.S. federal district court in Arizona, okay, included official language, chummy conversations with journalists, including an ESPN journalist, referring to Mr. Allen as Mr. Editor, while seeking feedback on an unpublished story that he sent to Allen to review. And a barrage of complaints about the state of the NFL. The emails were identical to some of those reported this week by the New York Times. In that story, the detailed homophobic, misogynistic comments by Gruden in emails with Allen and a day early with the Wall Street Journal. I just said that. Reported Gruden used a racist trope, blah, 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 blah. Okay, I'm not even going to get into that. But here's the important part. The emails were filed as a part of an effort by Daniel Snyder, the owner of the Washington football team, to compel Allen to produce discovery in a connection with the defamatory lawsuit that Daniel Snyder is pursuing in India against a media company for stories that it published in January 2020. So I can stop reading. So you know what that all that means is? That means that all of this stuff was used to try to protect or try to win a case for the Washington football team, who had a whole investigation done by the NFL, and the NFL refuses to let everybody see what those other emails are. Our situation with the Raiders, our coach, our season being derailed in the middle of it, seems to be all a plot and a plan to protect, allegedly, I'm going to say that again, to protect Daniel Snyder and the Washington football team. That's what it's coming out to. That's what it's coming down to. They've had these emails for 4 months. They've had these emails. The NFL has known about this since June. If anything, if you were going to do all of this, how come you couldn't do it back then and not let us go through all OTAs, all training camp, go through five games of the season, and then it leaks to the press? You don't leak that kind of information because that information is deflammatory. If it was going to be that, it should have been done in July. I mean, June. But it wasn't. It was done in the middle of the season to curtail and derail our team. And it's done exactly that at this point. And what makes it even worse is that ESPN's Adam Schefter, who we see all the time, who we look to him as being a beacon of information and a beacon of respect, actually was letting Bruce Allen, calling him Mr. Editor, meaning edit this story the way you want it to be edited before I put it out. So we don't know who's to be believed. Damore Smith and the NFL Players Association has asked the NFL to release the other information on the 650,000 emails to find out what else is going on. The NFL says they have no plans on releasing that. The lawyers that are for the ladies that are suing for sexual discrimination against the Washington football team They are asking to have those emails be released. And the NFL says, due to confidentiality statutes, we don't want to release the information. But where was Jon Gruden's, his rights when it came to having confidential information? That's the point I'm trying to make. Whether or not the punishment fits the crime or the crime was done, what it did was derail a football team that didn't have anything to do with what was going on with Washington and their legal affairs, nor ESPN, employees of ESPN coming out and doing stuff. So these are the kind of things that we got to think about. These are the kind of stuff that we're going to find out later on, that there's going to be other heads to roll. There's going to be other people that are going to pay the price for these kind of things that is going on. A lot of dirty macking, as we call it where I'm from. A lot of dirty macking, okay? Which means doing dirt against somebody else to derail their game, to derail what they're doing, to sabotage their success, to sabotage the threat of them actually winning. And that's what it is, you guys. But it's coming out. Every day, there's some new stuff that's coming out. All right, man, love all y'all out there, man. Raider Nation for life. We got to understand it's us versus everybody. And the sooner we understand that, the better we'll be. Salute.